Please welcome a founding member of Toto, a five-time Grammy Award winner, and one of the best guitar players of his generation, Steve Lukather.
Thank you very, very much. And I don't know who wrote that, but I'm not anywhere near the finest guitar player. Matter of fact, most of what I learned in being a session musician was from the section, man. I used to buy the records and listen to the parts that Danny would come up with and go, this is the kind of parts you got to come up with, the stuff that's not written. And that's what I learned from these guys. I mean, I've known them for 40 years. This is not a casual acquaintance. When I was just a zit-faced kid, these guys took me in. One by one, I worked with them on different projects, and wow, some of the most exciting, most well-rounded, interesting people who are geniuses at their own little thing, man. And when you put them together, it's a magical gumbo of genius, for lack of a better word. I'm very excited to be here to honor a group of musicians who meant so much to me and so much to the entire music world. I mean, seriously, what would, you know, It's Too Late be without Danny Kortchmar's solo? You know, where would that be, you know? I mean, Carol's a wonderful songwriter, no question about it, but what would Running on Empty be without Doerge's keyboard part, you know? And Sklar has played on everything from, you know, the Twilight Zone to, you know, the Mahavishnu Orchestra. I mean, he's an alien. And he did bail me out many times and was my best friend on the road when I was in not such a good time. And, of course, Russ Kunkel, who hired me to play on his first wife's Leah's record when I was a zit-faced kid, and he said, I felt so guilty asking for double scale, I actually called him and said, oh, you don't have to pay me that. And he laughed. He went, oh, I'll pay you that. What the heck, man? You know, you're worth it. These guys are not only musicians. They're my brothers, and they're people that I look up to and I revere as human beings as well as musicians. They set the standard and the bar so high. When we were doing our first album, I look in and I see Waddy and Cooch staring me down as I'm doing the solo to Hold the Line. I think if you'd have put a piece of coal up my ass at that time, the diamond would have fell out. But that's what you're like when you're around greatness, when you're around brilliance. I mean, the first time I worked with Sklar, I wanted him to like me so much, and he liked me even though I was a punk-ass, loudmouth kid, you know what I mean? And, you know, and Russ is always the gentleman, always the gentleman. And Craig only plays on what he wants to play on, when he figures he can bring the right stuff to it, and he always does. So, rather me bore you with any more of this, I'm gonna let the section tell their own story, but for that, let's go right to the source where the person was there from the beginning, from the very beginning, excuse the analogy, but he was there for the inception, the gestation, the birth, for the remarkable and early triumphs, which were vast. He's really the father of the section, and here I thought that was me. No, not true at all. They're older than I am. Anyway, while he's in New York and couldn't be here tonight, he sent his video. Please welcome the incredibly talented, legendary Peter Asher.
Hi, this is Peter Asher. Now, long time ago, long before I was a record producer and able to hang out in fabulous places like this, I used to be in a duo back in England called Peter and Gordon. And we had a few hits. And when we would go to play America, the local promoter would put together a band to accompany us, and we never knew what kind of band we were going to get. One of the best bands we got on one particular tour was a band called the King Bees. And one of the reasons this band was so good was that they had a great lead guitar player by the name of Danny Kortchmar. I loved him when I first met him. He was extremely self-confident and opinionated, almost, one could say, to the point of arrogance, but in a delicious way. And he also played extremely well. He and I both loved the same Steve Cropper licks. The difference was he could play them and I couldn't, and he played them very well. So he and I became firm friends. Not only was I an admirer and a fan, we became close friends. I used to stay with him in LA and so on. So we remained friends even after the Peter and Gordon era was over. And he later did me the not inconsiderable favor of introducing me to his childhood friend, James Taylor. So when time came to make James's first American album in Los Angeles, James and I knew who we wanted to play guitar on it, for sure. So that was the beginning of the little band we put together. A week or so later, when I was in LA, I went to a rehearsal of my friend John Stewart, the great singer-songwriter. And at that rehearsal, I heard this amazing drummer by the name of Russ Kunkel. He showed a degree of taste and interest in the actual song he was playing to an extent I'd never seen in a drummer before. And he played these beautiful kind of arranged fills, influenced a bit by Ringo and things like that, who I'm a big fan of too. So right away I said to Russ, we're making this record, will you please play on it? And that was the first half of our band. By this time, Cooch had also done me the great favor of introducing me to my songwriting idol, Carole King. So the piano chair on that particular album was already filled. Sorry, Craig, blame Cooch, not me. It wasn't until after we finished that album that we found Lee Sklar. James has sometimes given me the credit for that, but to my recollection, it was James who went to a rehearsal of a band called Wolfgang and called me from that rehearsal and said, I've found one of the best bass players I've ever heard in my life, better than Paul McCartney. And he was right. So Lee Sklar joined the band. And then, of course, finally, Craig Doerge joined and the section was complete. I was super impressed when I met Craig, not only by his great piano playing, but as an old folkie, I was impressed by the fact he was married to Judy Henske. I thought that was really cool. So there was the section, these four amazing players. They played on a bunch of records for me. They made some amazing records of their own. They ended up playing on everybody's records, along with various associate members like Waddy Wachtel, David Linley, Dan Dugmore, people like that. Between them all, individually and collectively, they became responsible for an entire school of music. They are therefore extremely deserving of this great honor of being elected to the Tech Awards Hall of Fame and receiving a Tech Award themselves. It's my privilege to be here. I wish I could be here in person, but I'm delighted to award them this very significant and well-deserved award. Congratulations to all of you. Thanks.
I've worked for Peter. He's a really nice man and done a lot of really great work. That was awesome, Peter. Now let's spend a little time with the music that made by the 2018 NAMM TEC Tech Hall of Fame honorees, the Section Video Package.
In the history of recorded music, there is a very short list of legendary studio combos that have earned their names as backing groups extraordinaire. The Wrecking Crew, the Funk Brothers, and Booker T and the MGs.
Well, I'm a steamroller, babe.
High on this list is The Section, an LA-based outfit anchored by a rhythm section of bassist Leland Sklar and Russ Kunkel on drums, along with Craig Doerge on keyboards and Danny Kortchmar on guitar. They made musical magic. The Section's roots actually sprung up in New York in the mid-60s. Danny Cooch Kortchmar, an up-and-coming young guitarist, joined a group called The Flying Machine, featuring a very young James Taylor. While The Flying Machine never took off and James headed to London, Taylor would ultimately be the reason that The Section came together.
I've seen fire and I've seen rain.
They were assembled in the studio by producer Peter Asher as the backing band for James Taylor's breakthrough album.
It's time to rock by my sweet baby James.
Then, after recording Taylor's Sweet Baby James, in quick succession, The Section played on Carole King's Tapestry album and Joni Mitchell's beloved Blue.
But I like you, yes I do, I like you fine.
Working with Linda Ronstadt, Jackson Brown, David Crosby and Graham Nash, Warren Zevon, and so many more from a golden era of singer-songwriters. They were dubbed the Mellow Mafia.
You've got a friend.
Cooch, Leland Sklar, the maestro of the electric bass, drumbeat major Russ Kunkel, and keyboardist Craig Doerge completed an aggregation that Mr. Taylor nicknamed The Section.
And it's too late, baby, now it's too late.
Kooch had also started playing with another singer-songwriter. Her name was Carole King. And The Section played a central role in the recording of her landmark debut album.
Well, let me tell you that it hurts so bad.
With Taylor's producer Peter Asher at the helm, The Section helped Linda Ronstadt record some of her finest work.
It hurts so bad if you walk away.
Doctor, my eyes.
And for Jackson Brown, they were the session men bringing some of his greatest songs to life. In the 70s, The Section also recorded three highly acclaimed albums under their own name. On many dates, they were joined by multi-instrumentalist David Lindley and Kooch's old pal Waddy Wachtel. And with the late, great Warren Zevon, there is no better example of his backing muscle and acumen than the immortal Werewolves of London. In recent decades, they have all added their sound and expertise to a variety of artists. Lee has the distinction of being one of the most recorded musicians of all time, playing on over 2,500 albums, including extensive work with Phil Collins. Danny also collaborated with Don Henley on his debut solo album, Building the Perfect Beast. Craig Doerge's work with the group and members of Crosby, Stills, and Nash has been essential to their live sound. And Russ Kunkel continues to perform but has also had a noteworthy producing career, including work with both Jimmy Buffett and Carly Simon.
These three guys who were the original band. Hey, please welcome Danny Kortchmar, Kooch, Lee Sklar, Rusty Kunkel.
Watch out, the singer, don't let her run around.
When James and Carole reunited for a tour in 2010, it was The Section who were essential, right there behind them.
By mine, I'm long gone to Carolina.
For nearly a half century, across the recording studios of L.A., The Section has played the score of a cultural soundtrack, carving a signature sensibility and rhythmic pulse behind iconic songs and artists. At a truly memorable musical moment in time, The Section were the house band that defined a generation, and they are indeed most worthy inductees into the 2018 NAMM TEC Hall of Fame.
Come on, everybody, stand up. These guys deserve this. I cannot put into words how much these guys mean to me as friends and colleagues. I did my first stuff with you guys. I have no right to do this, but I'm doing it anyway because I love them all like my own. Danny Kooch, Danny Kortchmar, right there. Russ Kunkel. Leland Sklar. And Craig Doerge. NAMM's 2018 Lifetime Achievement Honorees, the newest inductees to the NAMM TEC Hall of Fame. The Section! I love you, motherfucker!
Thank you guys so much. This is amazing. It's been such a fabulous run with these maniacs that we've had such a great life together. And the thing that's so special is it's not over. Everybody's still working their butts off. And thanks to also to all you guys, we get to enjoy all of your technology when we walk in the studios, and it just makes us sound better every time. So thank you for giving us the tools to do what we do. Next guy.
What an honor this is to receive this award. Thanks to the Tech Awards and everyone that helped put this on, to Rose Cherney, Ed Cherney, Lisa Roy, Karen Dunn, everyone that was involved in this. Thank you so much. We are so honored. Thank you.
We thank you so much. We've got to thank our brother Steve Lukather for that wonderful induction. One of our favorite humans. Please give it up for him. And we're so thrilled to be here. It is one of the joys and delights of my life, along with watching my children being born, to play with my dear brothers. And we will always love that, and we will always love each other. We thank you so much for this wonderful award. Thank you.
I'd like to especially thank Peter Asher for taking the time to make that wonderful thing he did for us in the front. And I want to thank the people that did the production job for the sections video, showing all those clips of us old guys. You know, when you come to NAMM your whole life, Lee and I live in the same neighborhood. We've been out in Pasadena for 40 years together. And we've been coming to NAMM every year. Lee lives down here during NAMM. But you never imagine someday you might get an award this nice. And so I'm very grateful and extend it to you. Thanks to the Tech Awards.